Records and rain tumbled with mighty force in the Big Bash tonight. Shane Warne's Melbourne Stars put the heat on the Perth Scorchers, bowling them out for just 69, the lowest total in Australian T20 cricket. Lasith Malinga caused the destruction, taking 6 for 7. Yes, you heard right, 6 for 7 runs, the best figures in the competition's history.
Brilliant Yorker. Absolutely brilliant. Malinga with 6.
And you wouldn't believe it, with the Stars chasing just 70 runs for victory, the heavens opened after 2 overs. Now, players thought 5 overs needed to be bowled for a result. However, that's not the case. The Stars win under the Duckworth-Lewis system. So an eventful night there at the Wacker. Still on cricket, and fast bowler Peter Siddle is biting back at critics, questioning his decision to give up eating meat and become a vegetarian. Siddle missed the series deciding test against South Africa through injury. The fiery quick insisting it had nothing to do with a lack of iron.
Probably in a better place than ever was. So for people to say that that's the problem and that's the reason why, they're the ones kidding themselves. They're not the ones out there having to do it and having to go through it.
Former Test batsman and proud Tasmanian David Boone passed on his knowledge of Belrive Oval to Michael Clarke today. Michael Hussey missed training with what we're told is a cold, but is expected to play in the first test against Sri Lanka starting on Friday. Kurt Tippett says he already feels at home in Sydney after training with the Swans for the first time this morning. The 25-year-old generated plenty of controversy since his messy departure from Adelaide, but is settling in nicely with the Premiers.
It was a perfect fit for me and I'm very excited. The future here is very bright. The prospect of coming here and playing alongside guys like Jared and Adam Goods and Sam Reid is just very exciting for me.
Due to his ban for salary cap breaches, Tippett's first game for the Bloods will be in round 13 against Port in Adelaide. GWS coach Kevin Sheedy has come face to face with his Premier League equivalent, the legendary soccer manager Sir Alex Ferguson at Manchester United HQ. The topics of conversation: football, racehorses and Paul Hogan's movie Crocodile Dundee. The Giants coach also met Man U defender Rio Ferdinand, who Sheedy says blew him away with his knowledge of AFL. That is terrific to hear. The standoff between the NRL and players over a pay dispute looks to be moving closer to a resolution, with Sharks captain Paul Gallen labelling today's talks the most productive yet. Negotiations have been ongoing since the league signed a new $1 billion TV rights deal, and the players want a bigger slice of the pie.
You know, they really come back with a pretty good offer today. It's not where we want to be, but it's certainly not too far off. So, yeah, things are moving forward.
The NRL shed little light on the situation, however. It did stress there had been no threat of a player boycott. To the EPL, and Sunderland is breathing a tad easier tonight after its 3-0 win over fellow league battlers Reading lifted it out of the relegation zone. Stephen Fletcher's terrific touch, the highlight for the Black Cats.
Sunderland double their advantage, and where would they be without Stephen Fletcher?
The result gives Sunderland a 1-point buffer from the drop zone, while Reading remains second last. Play of the day, and Caroline Wozniacki has caused a stir with her impersonation of good friend Serena Williams at an exhibition tournament in Brazil. Her decision to stuff her tennis outfit with padding, they were towels actually, has been labelled racist by some, but her opponent, Maria Sharapova, and the crowd, including Roger Federer, saw the lighter side. Now, you make up your own mind on this one, but Wozniacki says it was a laugh between friends. I think it's fair to say it's a controversial play of the day. I find this intriguing. Initially, I thought, it's not racist. I've been reading some of the blogs. One woman says, I do love how people can turn a black woman's body and sexuality into a caricature. I suppose if people are offended, maybe it's not about if Serena's offended, but if other people offended.
What's been Serena's reaction to it?
Well, it happened a couple of days ago, in fairness, and she's just said, we had a great time in Brazil, terrific, wonderful.
I think there are some occasions where offence is taken, not given. Mm. She said she didn't intend to offend, but as you say,
especially if they're good friends, surely there'd be no malice there.
Serena's often commented on the past on the fact she has a voluptuous body.
Fantastic body.
It's okay maybe for her to make fun, but is it okay for somebody else, even if it is a friend? I don't know.
I bet she didn't know that would happen.
I bet she didn't.